So basically, I just want to give you an example of trying to turn lemons into lemonade. I was in a situation where I don't really have a good setting, but I have a little bit of time, and so I wanted to record some of the covers that I've been playing over the years that I don't really know from memory that I have to do by looking at the words and the chords and everything. But I wanted it to not look like the exact same video that I shot. So what I did was I took a sheet, just a green sheet, and I stapled it, you know, to the ceiling. And the green screen, it just has to be different color. And if there are colors, like you'll see on some of my videos, when I remove this background, it also removes part of my shirt, removes part of my hair or face. But it still is better than having just junk in the background or being exactly the same every time. So that's what I did. The next thing I'm gonna do is show you just the basic things that I did on the software where it just turned into a process where at least it was better than just having nothing and just straight up from the iPhone 6S. But. So once you have a new project open in Premiere, you're just going to load in the track from your iPhone video. This is how it'll come in. And the first thing you're going to do is you're going to go over to and type in Ultra under the effects, and you're going to drop that on top of the video. There's two other things that you're going to add, which is you're going to type in Color. You're going to add the brightness, contrast, and the color balance. So these are all the things that I did to affect this video. First thing is the Ultra key, and that's the actual green screen. So you're just gonna click on the eyedropper and then pick somewhere. And you may have to try several different places depending on your lighting, depending on your situation. And there'll still be a bit of the background there. If you go under matte generation and then pedestal, take all the way up to 100%, it helps it quite a bit. There's still a little bit on mine, but it all depends on how well you set up your green screen. The other thing that I do a lot is the brightness, and I just take that down right off the bat. Puts it more in range with the background. And then the other thing you're going to do then is you're going to find a picture. So you try pictures or videos or whatever. This is a picture that I just have playing around with this one. I don't even know yet. But that's basically, once you drop that in there, you can change the color of the video, change the color of the pictures, the contrast, all that kind of stuff. One thing you might do is drop the opacity to make it more blend in with the background so it doesn't stand out. Another one is on the drop down on blends. You can do all kinds of different things where it integrates it with whatever background you've picked. And they all have different types of styles and play with it. But that's basically all I did as far as the video. Then the other thing that you do is with the audio, just a couple of quick little things is you right click on it, edit clip in Adobe Audition. And I'm definitely not a sound engineer or anything like that, and I've messed around with GarageBand before, but because this was integrated right here with Premiere and it opens it right up, and it doesn't affect the original, you still have the same iPhone video and audio that you did, but this just is on top of that. And then underneath the effects rack, you hit this little arrow here, and it gives you a couple different choices. And there's two things that I did, amplitude and compression, multi-band compressor, and then I just did a preset. I messed around with several ones, and this just seemed to be the best, was Pop Master. I put that on there, added it. The other one that I did was I went under reverb, studio reverb, and once again, I just did a mastering reverb. And I say apply. It applies that effects to the rack. Then all I do is say save. I go back to Premiere. That audio is now changed. And it's drastically improved from a production standpoint. So now you have a green screen. You're doing something different. It has a different feel. I can mess around with all the colors. You know, take the reds way down. There's all kinds of different things that you can just mess around with this. But that's basically all you got to do. And then you just export media. And then usually, I mean, if you're going to do a bunch of them, I just drop this to medium bitrate and it changes the file size ridiculously. But I'm on H624. Have it do the same. Output name, change it. Then you hit export at the end, and you've got yourself a video of you playing anywhere you want. So